Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Banished on Hard Mode. My name is Alex, and of course you are watching FCOG Gaming. Now, last time I left you off, we had just had our first trade ship come in, which, you know, it's a good thing. And, they're offering sheep. Which could be interesting. You know what? I think I'm gonna go ahead and make plans to buy those sheep. I just need to find a suitable place for a pasture. Which I'm not sure. Excuse me. Wow, that came out of nowhere. Which I'm not sure where the best place for that would be, to be honest. Maybe off in this little corner? Yeah, why don't we do that? And then we can kind of go from there. So let's... Let's just go ahead and make that our pasture. We can go ahead and turn on time. I do want to slow it down from 10x. Oops. And I need to turn off that. There we go. Let's go ahead and... We need to start with at least... Two. Let's see here. We have hide coats on their way. I do believe. Oh, I need a trader. I never got that set up. Okay, so let's take one of our builders, make him a trader. And since we've generally had enough wood, yeah, let's go ahead and take one of our foresters away. Now, hopefully, he will start hauling in more than just logs. We will see them. Hopefully. Kind of wish I would have turned him on a little bit earlier, just for the fact that I have nothing stockpiled up right now. Which kind of sucks. Let's turn time back up higher. And hopefully he will get to carrion. There he is. Yeah, we just have logs right now. Let's see how much those logs will go for. Probably 80. Yeah. Since, you know, I can do math and stuff. Alright, so he does have, he can grab some firewood. Let's max that out. We're at 440. We do have an extra laborer, which is great. Let's make him a forester. 20 hide coats. That's awesome. Just kind of waiting on him. Bring over enough goods to where it'll be worth our trouble. Let's have him grab some more hide coats as well. That'll leave us with 18 or so, which should be fine. So that's 600. Can I make the rest of that? I'm gonna need to get more logs. Let's keep 100 logs in there. That sounds reasonable. We've got the foresters for it, and it's an easily renewable resource, which is always good. Good thing that trade boat is very patient. He's been waiting there for about 3 months now, if this were real time. Alright, I only need 100 more units. Come on, guy. There we go. We can get 12 units. Hurry up and get the wood. Damn it. Alright. So, we'll go ahead and trade with him. We can go ahead and dismiss him. Let's go ahead and pause while we set some stuff up here. We'll have sheep. Sheepy. And, we are gonna need a herdsman, which is fine. Now, if I remember how this works, so it can hold a maximum of 7. And since they're sheep, I believe we can start shearing them before we actually slaughter them, which is good. So let's go ahead and just keep that 7 there. And we can... I don't remember if... It's been a long time since I've done livestock. Yeah, they just automatically go over there. Through the river, even. Which seems a little odd. Right over the fence, you know. Alright, so we've got that herdsman there. So I'm assuming... that they'll automatically shear them. Let's wait to confirm that, and go ahead and get some more stone going on. once we confirm that it is actually producing wool, we can change our tailor shop over to producing producing heavy coats, which will be nice. Let's get another gatherer in the mix. Actually, let's get another hunter in the mix, because we're gonna need that leather. Alright, and pretty soon we're gonna need more houses. Let's go ahead and throw another house down here by that pasture. Yeah, all sorts of people coming of age, which is great. The only issue is I have to keep an eye on the population to make sure that I have people to replace them. So, that's a thing. Any wool yet, which is fine. Wow, keep getting people. Pretty soon I'm gonna have to set up a mine somewhere, which is kind of unfortunate. Let's go ahead and we are out of iron. Let's go ahead and pull all the... I thought I saw some iron there. Let's find a nice deposit of iron to pull. There's a bunch of it. Here's some more. That'll be fine. A little bit out in the middle of nowhere, but it's still not insanely cold, so should be okay. All right, and that house is out of food, but should have some more food coming in shortly. And then more laborers. This is, I guess that's a good problem to have. I'm gonna have to figure out where to put my mine though. Probably don't want it right next to everything. This looks like it might be a spot. Maybe? Something like that. Yeah, that'll work. Oh, I have another trade vehicle. Awesome. So let's go ahead and pause for a second, see what they have to offer. They have a bunch of stuff, which will definitely help out our food shortage. So does not help out our firewood shortage, though. But they do like our herbs. We can go ahead and get some herbs traded for. Let's go with some beef. Let's do that. Looks like a fair trade. You can go ahead and dismiss them. Wow, so we have a crap ton of laborers, which will definitely come in handy once we get this mine up and running. In the meantime, I am going to need some iron. Which I guess they are gathering some iron right now, which is good. There's a bunch of stone down here. Might as well mark that to be picked up. Iron down there. What do we have up here? It looks like one block of iron or something. Something. And a bunch of stone. There's some iron right there. I'm just worried about running out of tools at this point. So many laborers. Which again, that's a good problem to have. Let's go ahead and max out our food production for right now. We can also get another herbalist. There another guy in the stone cutting thing. And there, I like that. Yeah, we are definitely running low on food, which is not good. People are starting to die of starvation. God dang it. Oh my god. This is not good. Okay, alright, so let's take off the, some of the stuff that's not necessary, and, just go ahead and max out our food production again. Luckily, this is only something I would say in the game, but luckily it's mostly just children that are dying off. Yeah, I'm a horrible person. Alright, so let's get that road connected up. Doing so well. Damn it. Okay, we need trying to figure out the best way to offset this. I'm just gonna keep keep trying to keep our food production maxed out, which sucks because it seems that the people that are making our food are the ones that keep starving, which is odd. Oh my God, this is not good. Okay, there's a little bit of food coming in. I don't have anybody manning the trading post, but I don't really need anybody to man it right now. Hunter died of starvation. Keeps dying. Hopefully this guy has some food for us. Got a bunch of fruit. So that's cool. Let's trade all our shit for some fruit. Huh? Please. Okay. So that should help. I do need to have somebody take over as trader. Oh my God. This is horrible. So that fruit does help a little bit. Might keep. Everybody from completely dying off. Herdsman died. Need to have a herdsman. Okay, we're gonna completely squash our stone industry for right now. Oh my God, people keep dying. Okay. Man. Excuse me, I don't know why I have the seasons here. Okay, we're gonna pause this. We need Okay, so our food production is about where it needs to be. We need to get at least a herdsman. We have a forester. Still have a bunch of iron to be collected. They're cold. Do I not have a woodcutter? Oh my God, this is horrible. At least it's spring. So it should start getting better, I guess. I don't know. This is horrible. My poor little people. They keep dying. But, we have a baby sheep, so that's something. I'm trying to look on the bright side here. Could probably change the recipe here. Let's go ahead and switch over to wool coat, since I did see some wool somewhere. Yeah, we have a little bit of wool. So we have some children being born. Might be a sign of things turning around a little bit. Getting firewood built back up, which is great. Getting a little bit more food built up, which is good. Okay, I think we might survive this. I mean, we lost about half of our population in the meantime, but we might survive this. Oh my gosh, what a stressful episode. But, we're up to four sheepies. Oh, a little baby sheepy. Aww. That's cute. Okay. All right, yeah, our food is definitely recovering right now, which is great. Love seeing that. Now I just need to have somebody pick up this iron so that we don't run out of tools, which would be bad. So, I think I have the spiral under control. Food seems to be the key there. But yeah. Man, that was stressful. Okay, so that brings us to about 30 minutes. I think I'm gonna put a cut in here. And yeah, hopefully next episode we can do a little bit of recovery now that people have stopped starving to death. Oh my god. It's horrible. So, yeah, until next time, remember not to starve. And if you liked this episode, go ahead and hit that like button. It definitely helps you out, probably more than you realize. Go ahead and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. And as always, thanks for watching.